Good afternoon.
We have a lot of new people.
That's true.
As Chair of the Senate's Housing, Construction, and Community Development Committee, it is a privilege for me to chair the Conference Committee on Environment, Agriculture, and Housing, and work with my colleague in the Senate, Assemblyman Engelbreit. I would like to thank our staff for their work on the budget, Nicola Coleman, Allison Bradley, and our Senate Counsel and Finance for their work. I'd like to introduce the members of our committee. Senator Joseph Griffo, who's the Chair of the Energy Committee. Senator Tom O'Meara, who serves as Chair of Environmental Conservation Committee. Senator Patty Ritchie, Chair of the Agriculture Committee. Senator Rich Funke, who is an alternate but also chairs the Tourism Committee. Senator Todd Kaminsky, Ranking Member of the Environmental Conservation Committee. And Senator Leroy Comrie, who is an alternate. I'll now introduce Senator Engelbreit for his introductions.
Thank you, Senator Little. I'm pleased to introduce the members of the subcommittee on the agriculture, environment, and housing. They include, Assemblymember Steve Simberowitz, the Chair of the Housing Committee, Assemblyman Bill McGee, the Chair of the Agriculture Committee, Assemblymember Dan O'Donnell, the Chair of the Tourism, Parks, Arts, and Sports Development Committee, and in addition, we have Assemblymember Addie Jenny, Assemblymember Kerry Werner, Assemblymember Cliff Crouch. Is Cliff here? Don't see him at the moment, but I do see Assemblymember Michael Fitzpatrick. So I'm led to believe, Senator, that the most important thing of the moment is to be sure that we designate our recording secretaries.
Secretary, thank you. And
so let me defer to you.
The Senate designates Lori Pozzola as the recording secretary.
And the Assembly designates Emily Sisko as the recording secretary.
Thank you. I think it's also important to note the agencies whose budgets are at our table. The Adirondack Park Agency, the Department of Ag and Markets, Department of Environmental Conservation, the Office of Parks, Recreation, Historic Preservation, the Olympic Regional Development Authority, the Energy Research and Development Authority, the Department of Public Service, the Division of Housing and Community Renewal, the State of New York Mortgage Agency, and the Hudson River Greenway Communities Council, the Hudson River Park Trust. I'd also like to add my colleagues here from the Senate for any comments in regard to our resolution and proposals that we have before us. Senator Ritchie.
Thank you, Senator Little. I would just like to put forward what the Senate has proposed with regards to ag and markets. The Senate proposes to restore $10 million in funds for local assistance and also adds $5.5 million for their Growing Strong proposal. The Senate also includes $5 million for local fair capital, $5 million for competitive grant programs for animal shelters, and adds $5 million for Cornell University College of Ag and Life Sciences. The Senate also puts forward 13 Article 7 proposals, one being the Senate proposes the language that doubles the farm workforce credit, retention credit. And during a time when our dairy farmers are struggling, we're on our third year of low milk prices, one of the one costs that we can help at the state level is doubling the farm workforce retention credit. Milk prices are at the federal level, but this is something that would go directly to the bottom line of the farmer's budget. So I would just like to take a moment and thank my colleagues for investing in our number one industry in New York.
Thank you. We all know how important ag is to New York State and to helping our farmers, especially in light of the low milk price right now. It's a real difficulty for them. Senator O'Meara.
Thank you, Senator. I look forward to the work of this committee going forward in our budget negotiations over the next couple of weeks. With regards to the environment issues, you know, major initiatives remaining intact, fully funding of the Environmental Protection Fund with some slight modifications to it, but continuing with the Clean Water Infrastructure Act and dealing with our clean water in the state. We've got a lot of good things going on. One of the issues we want to amend in the Environmental Protection Fund is to conduct a waste stream study through Cornell University to look at our entire waste stream in New York State and determining the best ways to move forward in the future on dealing with the waste that we have, both in regards to food waste, which is a major issue that we will remain discussing on how to deal with the food waste, but also plastic bags and many other things that make up our waste stream. We do also have, I think, an important amendment to the governor's Empire Forest for the Future initiative, providing greater relief to local governments for what tax revenues may be lost by areas being designated. That's just a few of the items that I wanted to highlight.
Okay, thank you. Senator Griffo, Chair of Energy.
Hi, Senator Little. Glad you can see me down here.
I can always see you.
I have a little chair at the bottom, so you all look very good as I look up. thank you very much. We have a number of items relative to the energy subject matter in the budget. Some of the highlights is that we would like to look at allowing heavy users of electricity customers to be able to use self-directed banking approaches to clean energy charges. We want to require the Department of Financial Services and Superintendent to have oversight over the Green Bank, similar to what they do over regular banking functions. And we will continue to look at developing Green Business, Green New York programs. We are looking to establish an affordable energy tax credit. We want to continue to examine and update Recharge New York to make it more effective to the people who have access and need this. We would like to continue to review, and we are rejecting at this point in time NYPA's request for broader authority and the right to own renewable facilities. We have many concerns about the Power Authority deviating from its purpose and original mission. They now have oversight and the responsibility of the Canal Corp, and we think that the more they continue to place new initiatives and potential burdens on the agency, this could be problematic, and we are concerned about that and would like to have that ability. And we're also rejecting some of the taxes on energy, particularly on 18A. Thank you, Senator Little.
Thank you. And as Chair of Housing, I want to stress how important it is in this budget that we recognize rural and neighborhood preservation companies by restoring and adding some funding to them. We create a new $10 million manufactured home park preservation loan fund that would assist mobile home parks. We also want to add $10 million for affordable senior housing programs to go with the $125 million that we were able to get into the $2.5 billion for senior housing. We also want to bifurcate the state low income housing tax credit, which should help with making it more attractive for tax credits. And we reject the executive's proposal to defer the state low-income housing tax credit. And we also have some measures in the our resolution to address health, safety, and living conditions for NYCHA tenants by imposing independent monitoring and oversighting, as well as an expansion of the city's 311 program. So, Assemblyman Engelbright, your chairs.
Okay. We'll do our chairs first, and then I know we have other members who want to offer some thoughts. Let me begin. I'd just like to offer a few words about the Assembly Environmental Conservation budget as proposed. We voted on it yesterday, and we're proceeding appropriately into our first meeting here today. So we're on target, even though we don't yet have table targets. That will catch up with us as we go forward. I'm very pleased, though, that our Environmental Protection Fund has remained at $300 million. And although we're pleased with that large headline, there are a few changes in terms of the specific allocations within that amount that I'd just like to highlight that we've proposed. One is to increase environmental protection funding for the zoos, botanical gardens, and aquariums program, and for the land acquisition program. We also propose to increase funding levels for environmental justice grants and invasive species eradication. And we also include funding in the EPF for the combat of the spread of Lyme disease and other tick-borne illnesses. In addition, the Assembly includes the New York State Climate and Community Protection Act within our budget. We know and believe strongly that climate change is real, it is happening, it is victimizing our communities, and it is perhaps the single biggest issue that faces our state, nation, and world today. The Assembly also includes language to ensure the capital funding for harmful algal blooms is available for any water body in the state that may need to have help. Let me go next to Steve Simberwitz, the Chair of Housing.
Thank you, Assemblyman.
Anything working over
No.
there?
No.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. This year's Assembly budget proposal addresses several housing issues that have been of the utmost concern to our constituents and to the Assembly majority, including, of course, the need for safe, affordable housing across the state. That's why we've added $9 million above the executive's proposal for neighborhood and rural preservation programs. We're also allocating $275 million to support public housing, with $200 million of that earmarked for NYCHA and $75 million for the rest of the state, and we want to continue the provision of $6 million to modernize existing public housing statewide. We understand the power of a multifaceted approach when it comes to improving the life of hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers living in NYCHA developments. So we not only propose funding for NYCHA capital project in this year's budget, but we are asking to authorize the use of design-build procurement process to expedite its much-needed facility repairs. In addition, we would require NYCHA to submit two annual reports on its responsibilities and activities regarding lead-based paint poisoning prevention and control. Both reports would be made public to ensure transparency and to help gauge the authority's compliance with state and federal guidelines. It is our belief that, together, the funding and programmatic changes we've proposed will help put New York's public housing developments and the people who call them home on the right track for future success. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman. Chairman Bill McGee.
Yes, thank you. And Larry, you've heard that the problem that there is with the agriculture right now, New York's number one industry, particularly dairy farmers, are having some difficult times. This budget does a little to address that. The Assembly proposal was $175.25 million, an increase of $13.24 million above the executive proposal. The Assembly accepts the executive proposal and recommends no change in the state operations. And then there's a list of aid to localities that, quite frankly, is not enough, and we need to focus on appropriating some more for agriculture so that the agriculture industry can continue to operate and hopefully expand in New York. We have an opportunity to address some of those issues in the process that we're going through right now, and I strongly support that. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Chairman. Assemblymember Daniel O'Donnell, Chair of Tourism, Parks, Arts, and Sports.
Thank you very much. I'll pass.
Thank you. We'll come back. I know we have other members, but I wanted to at least have the chair speak, and I know you have other members as well.
Right. Thank you. Senator Leroy Comrie, some comments.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you. I'm hopeful that as the budget process continues, we are able to as our Senator colleagues have expressed in their One House budget, fully restore the governor's cuts to vital agricultural programs, from Cornell Lab Services, extension outreach to farmers, and research in agricultural and educational programs, to the support we show for our various community associations. This funding is too important to not be in the final budget. Be the hand that we are dealt, I urge our colleagues to also ensure that our agricultural youth and our often struggling farmers have the resources that they need to succeed, and also that the Humane Society can continue to be funded again this year, as it was last time for the first year. In environmental issues, I'm pleased that all parties are recommending a strong $300 million EPF and look forward to continuing the state's momentum on addressing water quality issues and addressing blighted properties that are often clustered in disadvantaged communities. And I hope that in the next year we can also deal with the groundwater problems in Southeast Queens and that are affecting the Long Island aquifer, and that we can also make sure that the asthma study is brought into Queens and Brooklyn as well, as it's only in two boroughs right in the budget right now. In the housing area, it's no secret that we face a shortage of affordable housing throughout the state, but especially in New York City. While the state has invested significant resources in the past few years, it is not enough to meet the demand for all of our constituents. With regard to NYCHA, I would note that the Senate Democratic Conference has called for an additional $500 million in much-needed funding, and we do not support any additional oversight without additional funding. Allowing design build for NYCHA is immediately needed, and we would hope that it would allow for significant MWBE participation, including HUD Section 3 requirements and the use of project label agreements. I hope as budget negotiations continue, we can all agree on additional funding for affordable housing statewide and for the preservation of our existing affordable housing, in particular the New York City Housing Authority. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
Assemblywoman Addie Jenny.
Thank you. As we move through this process, I would, just point to the bipartisan approach of restoring agriculture programs in this budget year. Agriculture is our largest economic sector, and it's extremely important that we take that into consideration and make restorations. But the financial struggles of our farmers throughout the state should probably also be addressed at other tables, because the support that is necessary is beyond the scope of what this budget area table really can accomplish. So it really should be discussed at more than one table. But I'm very happy to see that we will be pushing the issue of having statewide programs to address water quality, specifically the algae problem that we're having across the state, the need to preserve our open spaces and farmland for future generations, and also to have a balanced energy policy that doesn't burden one state, a part of the state, more than the other, but also gets us towards our targets of clean energy generation. So I think we have a lot of common ground to move from, but some things that may traditionally be found in this area of the budget, that we may need to push it in other areas, such as economic development as well.
Thank you, Assemblywoman. Assemblywoman Carrie Werner.
Thank you, Mr. Engelbreit. I would just echo what my colleagues have said, that agriculture is our top industry in New York State, and more important than that, they are the 1% that feed the 99% of the rest of us. And it is really important that we, particularly in economic times like our dairy farmers are facing now, that we recognize the role that the state has in supporting that industry so that it can continue to be strong. And I would add to that that we have one of the best land-grant universities in the country. It used to be the best land-grant university in the country, and that an underinvestment by the state in our in the programs in our land-grant university has eroded its position as the number one ag research or institution. And I think it is very critical that in this year we invest monies to ensure that our land-grant university and that Cornell's plant sciences and dairy programs remain at the top of the industry. So I look forward to working with my colleagues. I know this is a bipartisan issue because we are all part of the 99% that get fed by the 1%. Thank you.
Thank you, Assemblywoman. Mr. Fitzpatrick, did you have some thoughts to add?
Thank you, Steve. Just we on Long Island are very concerned about agriculture because the North Fork of Long Island is some of the most productive farmland in the entire state. We're not dairy-centered, but we are agricultural-centered. The algae blooms and the nitrogen in our water supply, we hope the budget can help us deal with those issues as well. And just on housing, affordable housing is a need in many parts of the state, not just the city, and we want to make sure our rural areas are helped in that regard also. But we stand ready to help in any way we can on our side of the aisle. Thank you.
Thank you for your thoughts. You remind me to brag a little bit about Long Island. We have, because we're maritime, we have two growing seasons. So we're very fortunate to be the beneficiary of that. And we also have these extraordinary glacial lush soils. So we are a part of the enterprise of farming that is the number one enterprise in the state. And we're an important part of it, even though we invented suburbia.
Okay, unless anyone has any further comments, which I think we're okay, we will conclude this meeting. We do not have our target amounts, and as you can see, we have many, many issues. But we look forward to working together to come up with a good budget on time. So I'm not sure when we'll meet again, but we will get notified, and you will all be notified as well. Thank you for attending, and thank you to everyone for participating.
Thank you all.